Today I give God thanks for the Holy Spirit that is in our midst. I greet our pastors, Pastor Charles and Pastor Kofi. I want to thank God for all the saints of God. Special greeting to my wonderful special wife. Today I believe the word of the Lord that God has given me. If you receive it today, it will change your life forever. I believe there's a power in the word of God. Today we're going to read from Hebrews chapter number 11.
And here comes from Hebrew form,
we read from verse 8 to 11, please. If our man find it, she can begin to read for us.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 11, verse 8 to 11. Ana Hebrew form ma eti dubako, chiche mu mwa chiko si dubako. Making kind eradiasem.
Amen.
Eti fiasem, wasi Abraham. Jide na ofre Abraham no, odi ti free ko baby a dachi, ubenya hose e japadie. Na ofri e di a na onim di e oko. Jide na ode koye oho wo boshe asase no so se ananafuo di esu. Na one boshe krono ara edidi fuo Isaac eni Jacob tina into madainu. Na otwen kuro a ewo fapim. A me cheche fuo ne yefuo ne unyankopon. Eti du bako. Jide na sara nsu di nya ahwode nyi sen. Ebre a watre ni nyini mu. If we say obu die o share no bono no kwafo Ewurde asemi amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much, man of God.
And I was saying amen.
Reading from the King James Version, Hebrews number chapter 11, beginning from verse 8 to 11. The Bible said, by faith Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, obeyed. And he went out, not knowing whether he went. By faith he sojourned in the land of promise, as in strange country, dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked for a city which had foundations, whose builder and maker is of God. Verse 11. Through faith, also Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed, and was delivered of a child when she was past age, because she judged him faithfully who had promised. Let's pray.
Receive us more fire.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Lord, I worship you. Amen. Father, I praise you.
Amen.
I thank you for who you are. Lord, by faith, Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter.
Amen.
Chose rather to suffer afflictions with the people of God.
Amen.
Than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. Holy Father, I pray for your people in the name of Jesus,
amen,
that today they will refuse,
amen,
to be called anything that does not belong to them.
Amen.
I pray, Lord God, that you will do a new thing in our midst.
In Jesus' name.
Father, I pray for those that are looking for breakthrough.
Yes, Lord.
Those that are looking for healing.
Oh, yes, Lord.
I pray you will set somebody free today through your word in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I believe you.
Yes, Lord.
I know you will do it.
Oh, yes.
In the magnificent name of Jesus, shall we shout amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much. Man of God, nice to see you, Pastor Kofi.
Thank you.
Pastor Kofi, hey, you see yourself.
We missed you last week.
Yeah, now what you said, I feel bad.
Amen.
Genesis, Hebrews chapter 11.
Verse
number 8. The Bible said by faith. You see, I want to talk about faith. But oftentimes when we talk about faith, some of us, we begin to think that if we will come to church and do things, and when we get ourselves into trouble, we will use Jesus as the one that is going to sort it out for us. We oftentimes think because we have faith, so the Lord is just going to sort it out for us. But today, what I want you to understand, when it comes to faith, it's not just that so easy. Faith is not just having everything nice going for you. Brothers and sisters, when we talk about faith, the word of God is clear. The Bible said by faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he after received for inheritance. Brothers and sisters, it wasn't easy. Because when you begin to think about when the Bible used the word faith, sometimes we think when we pray, when we do things for God, it shows that we are people of faith. But today, what I want you to know that sometimes faith that you got can cause some pain for you. The pain that is
going
to cause for you sometimes is so difficult. We see in the life of Abraham, it wasn't easy. But today, some of us believe that because we have faith, we can just speak to the mountains and say, be thou removed, and it will be done. Not really?
And yes,
I don't think so. But what I want to challenge you today, when you see what happened in Abraham's life,
so we didn't see Abraham.
We want the blessings of Abraham.
Yeah, Abraham is sure to be.
But are we ready to go through what Abraham went through?
Abraham.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
When I was thinking of this message, what came into my mind? If I was to name this message, the title is simply "Go out in Jesus' name." Can you turn to your neighbor and say to him, "Go out in Jesus' name."
Go out in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
You see, when you say to yourself that, "Look, I have mobile phone." And maybe you have been given a limit call. If you go over that limit, you're going to start paying that bill. So when you said to me you have faith, it's not about maybe you sitting there waiting for God to do things for you. Because we see in the life of Abraham, the Bible said God called him to go out. And he went out. Today I want to challenge you that there are things that you have to go out and do something for it. Because if you don't get up and just sit down and believe that God is going to do for you, it's not going to happen. You have to get up and go out.
Amen.
And I do believe very strongly that God is going to do something special for you today.
Amen.
I believe with all my heart. By faith.
Amen.
Because when you look at Christianity, especially when you watch the God channel, oftentimes they said if you have faith, you know, you can do this and this and that, and it's going to happen. But when you check in your life truly, there are things that is happening in your life that you know that you need the word of the Lord to help you there. So when I look at the word when he said obey, Abraham, if you read other writings, we understand that his father have a business and they were idol worshippers.
So he called by one church mona na Abraham na busia for no mo bibi pa na ni mo no mo abosom.
His father was very, very rich.
No, you be a order na moyo before ye.
So Abraham was in comfort zone.
Do no no you be a or ni papa was kind no ko no was ka no inyare.
And God called him to come out from that.
Ni mo nyakopo fa ni say own free sense kan ni down no mra.
It wasn't easy to leave your family and friends. But Abraham, when we talk about he had faith, and we are going to be blessed by the faith of Abraham. What you have to understand, the scripture is clear. Abraham was saved by grace.
Abraham and Abdomson Yeje, no.
It was 430 years after Abraham, the law was given.
Neye in fear Hannah and Ediasan, 430 years, and son and Rani Edema.
And the Bible said that Abraham, even as Abraham believed God, and it was counted to him a righteousness.
Was it Abraham Ji Nyankupondi, Neye Namsuma, Ebu Nitrine?
So we begin to understand that. It was not by the works of the law that Abraham was saved. So today, what I want to say to you today, when you look at your life, it's not about what you have done that is going to get you saved. Our sister came and he read it. He said, for by grace we are saved. And when you read the letters of Paul, you will hear this phrase, Paul saying, I do not frustrate the grace of God.
Now here and since my Paul
You see, he said, if righteousness come by the law, then Christ dead is in vain.
Also said, I don't know
so you understand that it is not about our own right way that we are going to be saved. And what I was looking then, I checked again in Galatians chapter 3 verse 18, he said something that is very interesting. And I was thinking about this when God said that it really blew my mind. It was interesting to me. Verse 18, this is what the word of God said.
Galatians 3:18.
It said, for if the inheritance be of the Lord, it is no more promise, but God gave it to Abraham by promise.
Amen.
Amen.
If the inheritance,
sir, I did you know,
be of the Lord, then it is no more a promise.
Say, if you are there, then you worship you. If you run, then you worship you.
So we begin to understand that you see, whatever is happening in your life right now, it is not about what you are going to do that will make God to save you. But you have to do something that would God would know that my son really fear me or my daughter really fear me. The Bible said, before faith came, we were kept under the law. Shut up unto faith which should be revealed after. Shut up unto faith which should be revealed after. After that faith came, we were no longer under schoolmaster. So what I want to today encourage you is that it is important for you to know that when the Bible talked about, but after that faith came, we no longer under the schoolmaster. So the journey of faith is not going to be easy for you. When you have faith in God, sometimes things is gonna get tough. And I know it's going to get tough. When I look at somebody like Abraham, when the Bible talked about this man that we have faith, you have to understand in Genesis chapter 12 when God said, now the Lord have said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land which I will show thee.
It's
not easy to leave your family to go to another country. You don't know anybody there. You are a stranger there. That is very painful. To leave everything behind. Because he didn't come from poor family. But he left everything. That will cause him some pain. It's like today as we are sitting here. Let me use this example. If you are like a consortium or GP practitioner and you earn like about £500,000 a
year,
then you heard a voice that God is saying to you, leave everything in the United Kingdom. I wanted to use a country like Sudan, but I don't know anything about Sudan. Because to Sudan is a very poor country, but I want to use my country as an example. For example, to leave everything and go to Ghana somewhere like Sevioso. That you giving up your work, you giving up everything, and you said you have faith. Would you do that? And maybe you're going to be eating yam. Maybe your breakfast will be egg bemi. That's not easy. That is what happened to Abraham.
And now this added to Abraham.
He gave up everything. And the Bible saying, even the land not knowing whether he went. Brothers and sisters, if you really have faith, can you tell your neighbor it's a time to get up and go? You have to get up and do something. Maybe today you have seen some beautiful woman that you want to propose and marry to. If you're sitting down and said you have faith, that woman will come to me. It's not going to happen. It will never happen. You have to get up and do something. Today I want to challenge you today. When you see what happened to Abraham, the Bible said he sojourned in the land of promise. This was not easy for him. But today, what are you doing in your life? You don't want to work full time, but you expect to get £1,000 a week. It's not going to happen. Brothers and sisters, I said it's not going to happen. You want to work only 3 hours a week? And you're planning to buy a mortgage in the United Kingdom? Can you tell your neighbor that faith will not work? It will not happen. It is a time for you to get up and do something. It is time for us to stop using faith as a therapy. Using faith as I can do all things. And claiming and naming. Brothers and sisters, I said it's not going to happen. But I do believe very strongly. If you truly have faith, let me give you an example. When you look at somebody like Paul, this is a man that has faith. This man said he suffered many beatings. He suffered shipwreck. And he said, even false brethren came to spy our liberties. He said, I was led into a basket to escape in Syria. This man said he suffered so many things. It's not easy. This is a man that has faith. But I heard him in book of Acts chapter 19. Acts chapter 26 verse 19 and 20. He said, "Oh King Agrippa, I was not disobedient to the heavenly vision. I was not disobedient unto the heavenly vision. Everything he went through, he said, I was not disobedient. In other words, he refused to give up. Brothers and sisters, today maybe you have got faith. And things is happening to you that you fail to yourself. You don't deserve to go through this. I came to encourage you to hold on. I believe that God is going to help you. If you hold on to that faith, don't give up. Continue to believe God. Because we see in the life of Abraham, he went through so much painful experience. But because he believed God, the Bible says it was counted to him as a righteousness. And today, if you believe, if you hold on, if you don't give up, then the Bible said, through him we are going to be blessed. And then I see another witness that God witnessed concerning Abraham. Brothers and sisters, this was powerful. It was very powerful to me. It's taken in Genesis chapter 18, verse 19. God is testifying of this man. He said, for I know him that he will command his children and his household after him, and they shall keep the way of the Lord and to do justice and judgment, that the Lord might bring upon Abraham that which he has spoken of him. Today, can God testify about you and I? What would the testimony be today? Brothers and sisters, this is God testify of this great man. And I think it's very interesting. Because when I was thinking about it, I always, when I read the Bible, when I study the Bible, I always pause and ask questions. God is testifying of Abraham. And we want the blessing of Abraham. So what are we going to do? We have to get up and do something. Brothers and sisters, I said we have to get up and go in Jesus' name. So we see in verse 9 of Hebrews chapter 11. He said, by faith he sojourned in the land of promise. Christianity is like a journey. It's like a roller coaster.
I say,
Christianity is a fight. Christianity is a struggling. It's a very, very hard fight. Because for this man of God, when the word said, he sojourned in the land of promise. It wasn't easy. Brothers and sisters, then I begin to understand why God was testifying about Abraham. You see, when you study Genesis chapter 13 between Abraham and Lot, the Bible said that Abraham said to Lot, his brother's son, don't let any strife came between you and I.
Now Abraham catched a Lord said, Emma Bibi Biara Emma Menewintem.
Between your head man and my head man.
Because
we are brothers.
If you say in your arm.
In other words, if I'm speaking to you now, we can say we are brothers and sisters. He said, the land is before you. If you choose the left, I will go to the right. If you depart to the right, then I will go to the left. You see how faithful this man was. When problem came between him and his brother. So today, if problem comes between you and your brother or sister, how are you going to deal with it? You see the spirit of humility in Abraham in that
text.
When you read the narrative of that story, it is very interested for this man putting everything to his brother's son Lot. To choose the better of the land. Brothers and sisters, that I call is
repaid.
But today, how are you dealing with your brothers and your sisters? Are you really trying to push them down and to crush them? I don't believe that is the faith. That's what I said to you earlier on, that faith is not easy as we think. Brothers and sisters, faith sometimes is a time when everything looks dark around you, you can still hope that God is going to give you the breakthrough. When you are praying for other people's children, and your own children are messing up. They are getting their breakthrough, but it seems nothing is happening to your children. But I believe in the name of Jesus Christ that when we see in the life of Abraham, what he demonstrates in Genesis chapter 13 was so powerful for us today. Because what the enemy is after is not about your little money. The enemy wants to attack you where you cannot even breathe. So today I want to encourage you that don't say, I have faith, so I'm going to sit down. You have to get up and do something in the name of Jesus Christ. And as I'm going to end this message, I don't believe very strongly that we see in the life of Abraham what he did between him and his brother's son. God is challenging us today that whatever is happening in your relationship, to do something about it. Oh, you saying even if I greet them, they don't respond to me, but you still have to get up and go and make it right.
I say, send me chair, mumpa, mumfi me. What say, man, tosun ye? I tosun aye. Kona kwenye ye.
Do it again.
Ye biem zatia ye biem.
Until peace will come.
Eko sisi afunge ba unomi anita.
That is what I call faith.
Eno na my friend say GDA.
Faith is not about praying and naming and claiming.
Anyesa wobam paye na wodi na break it through.
That's not faith.
Eno ni ye GDA.
So we see that in this text, he said in verse 10, for he looked for a city which had foundation, whose builder and maker is of God. Amen.
Amen.
That is what you should be looking for in your life. I believe that if you have that in mind, then you're going to try and make peace with your brothers and sisters. It's very important because the enemy is going to attack you, the area that is so important for you.
If you say upon for remember here one gas and attack you.
That is why it's going to attack.
And hold on, Baba show us.
It's not worry about your shoe and your shoelace going missing.
And yeah, be a watch why you should know what black lace will become myself.
The devil is not concerning about the suit you're gonna wear.
I'm sure dressing or dressing poop.
He wants to attack you where he hurts so much.
Show us a baby more than I went to be born.
But what I want to say to you, you see, one time, maybe you might, when you see me and my wife laughing and holding hands, you say, this couple, they get on very well.
You see,
one time, the enemy attacked my marriage. My wife, she might not like this. And I have to seek for a counsel. And she even said to me, you being a minister, why do you need a counsel?
So we are so far into our goals of being too.
I said because I love you.
I say if you say do you.
You see, because what the enemy is going to do is going to attack your marriage.
It's
going to hit you so hard.
So obey hit you at the deeper.
And if you don't really seek for counsel, that will help you and your marriage. It's going to destroy you. And brother and sister, you will be bitter. You will be bitter. And I challenge you today, whatever is happening in your life, you have to be real with God. If your marriage is not happening and you come and stand here and say, everything is fine.
So why you going to
that's a hypocrisy. The enemy plan is to attack your children. But if you believe God through faith, you will not break that marriage whatever happened in Jesus' name. I believe with all my heart, the enemy is after the most important areas of your life. But I believe in the name of Jesus because you have got faith. You are going to hold on. If you have people talking about you, what you do? I've seen people leaving this church because people are talking about me. That is not faith.
And no one did it.
Brothers and sisters, this is not a time to give up.
When because
you have heard some preach that have preached, or Pastor Kofi or Pastor Charles have preached that you don't like it, and you are prepared to leave this church. Are you prepared to leave this church? That's not faith. You have to hold on. Whatever happened to you, I believe that is what I call faith. And God is going to make things better for you in the name of Jesus. I believe with all my heart. In verse 11, he talked about true faith. Also, Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed and was delivered of a child when she was past age because she judged him faithfully. who have promised.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, when it comes to God, I don't know about you, but sometimes it seems like God's way of doing things, it frustrates us. Because when God promised them a child, the thought it was late. So they have to use plan B.
Didn't see another plan.
But do you know, I feel the same sometimes. And I believe that some of you sitting here today, you're feeling the same. That God has promised you something that is taking too long. See, since I was growing up, there have been so many prophecies in my life that I'm going to be blessed, I'm going to be great. I'm sure some of you sitting here right now, you have had prophecy in your life, men of God prophesying to you that you'll be great, you're going to be blessed. And those days, I was thinking, when is it that great, when is that blessing is going to come from? When I look at my life, am I blessed?
Yes,
I would say yes.
Because I am, yes,
has it been easy? The question is no.
Oh, yes.
In your life, if I ask you, are you blessed? The question is yes. Has it been easy? It's no. Because you know that God have used some of you to invite people to the United Kingdom here that have been a blessing to your family. Some of us sitting here today, for us being blessed being in the United Kingdom, we have able to help others in Ghana and all over the world. I think that is a blessing for God using you. You see, and I was asking God that, Lord, I have so many prophecies that this is going to happen, that. And God said to me, he's going to show me a sign. He said he's going to give me something that I will be convinced. You see, last year I have a minister that was in a former Ghana president, Kufuor's cabinet, a secretary of state, came to live with me in the United Kingdom here for about 2 months. This is somebody that is well respected in the whole Ghana and in the world. Man with the millions of pounds. If you see his mansion in Ghana, you will be shocked. He has mansions more than four. This man was living with me in the United Kingdom here, and my aunties and people that were close to me were asking that, why did this minister came to you? It's like you living here and the defense secretary of state will come and said, I want to live with you for about 2 months. And God gave me the opportunity to witness to him and preach the gospel to him. And that is what I want to say to you today, that you are sitting here today, God has promised you so many things. If you hold on to the promise of God, God is going to give you the breakthrough in Jesus' name. This is not a time time to give up. This is not the time to say someone is talking about me.
And that's what we come and
if we are committed to invite people to church, and we are committed to build the church of God. This is not Pastor Charles' church. This is not Pastor Kofi's church. This is not Evangelist Michael's church. I want to tell you today that this is the kingdom of God. We are kingdom of God people. So, as we see in the life of Sarah,